Friday, October the 30th. Sadly, we're not moving in as we expected. Tiles are missing from the stairs and for doing the kitchen. The painting's delayed. The windows are about 3 weeks late. So there's still a lot to be done. We were going to move upstairs here, but there's lots of finishing touches still required. It's looking amazing. But we've decided I'm going to rent an apartment for another month. And they promised that in 2 weeks' time we should be here. This is the view now from the office. See, most of the internal upstairs is completed, but we still need secure windows, we still need attached light fittings and things. The doors have been put in, but obviously need finishing. The skirting boards and everything there. We've got spotlights in the roof, in the entrance hallway. As you can see, the windows are in. Beautiful light, lots of space. Francesca's bathroom is finished. Apart from the accessories, towels and everything you see. The wooden look tiles look great. Nice, clean, clear, simple. Lots of space, which is what we wanted. And onto the main landing into Francesca's room, where we've basically added a nice blue wall there at the end, the window as well. We've got some ceiling fans, and we need to sort out light fittings. We've just added a little bit of colour, and at the far end there we will be putting a fitted wardrobe. And just taking you out again onto the terrace, which has now been tiled. Still some edging needs sorting and everything. Again, days like today, and just appreciate the views that we have. There's been a problem also with the blind in the master bedroom. They've managed to crack a pane of glass in the patio door. So all these little things being sent to test us, but we're a lot closer than we were, and it is looking amazing. Back on for landing into the master bedroom. We've had some basic furniture returned. We're doing some makeshift wardrobes for the time being. This is a super king bed, which used to look huge. It took about a whole last bedroom. But as you can see now, hardly takes up any space at all. This beautiful big room. There's more old furniture and TVs in that. We've put ceiling fans on. The walk-in wardrobe already, so we've got some makeshift wardrobes for now. For storing some bits of clothing. Oop, make sure I don't fall over. And again, take you through to our bathroom. I've stuck a speaker in there just now. Give me some music whilst I'm sorting things out. Sink's been attached. We just need to put a mirror in there. The window, the bath. And sadly, they cracked the frosted glass there, so that's closed. We see the mirror, the nice walk-in shower. Nice space there. For the loo, we're going to put a towel radiator heater in there. And just to say, if I'm sat in the bath, that's the view up to Sierra de Micos. Rather beautiful. So from outside, you can see there's still lots of debris everywhere. All the air has got to be tiled. We still don't have a front doorstep, but we do have a nice, secure front door. And which leads us through to the hallway. When the windows are at the end, they'll give a much better feel of the space, but all the false ceilings have been put in, the spotlights are still to go in. Josh's room is looking really great. Again, the false ceiling with some spots will go in. We've got his furniture. It's all been rendered. And we're utilising the space under the stairs there. Be a good storage area for him, or if he wants to have his gaming centre in there. And that's the extra bit that we added by knocking the wall down, where we'll sort out his fitted wardrobes, which will lead into the ensuite, which is still to be finished. So we'll zoom you back round. It's pretty hard to imagine what this is going to look like, but you can get an idea now of how much we've advanced. The archway's gone. A false ceiling has been put in there to hide all the piping. This will be the dining room area. And then in what used to be the playroom, all the floors have been evened out. It looks amazing. Aluminium doors removed. We're going to put some sliding stable light doors on there. Windows are still to go in. Patio windows at the end that lead to the garden. Window on the left there. And that is where the old fireplace used to be. So this is a great room now that could be used as a bedroom if somebody wanted, but we're going to use it as a games room and TV room for children. So we've got the nice big L-shape living space. So close, but so far. And then this entranceway here leads into the downstairs bathroom, which still completely needs tiling and fitting out. And what used to be Josh's bedroom with the fitted wardrobe made of bricks, they've removed that now. And this is a really good size spare bedroom, guest bedroom, and we'll just put basic furniture in. I'm not going to take you outside today, but if you look through the windows here, you can see there's still a lot of work to be done out there. April the 30th, 2018.